Hello everyone, I am back again. Super excited to see everyone. Of course, you guys know I just love talking to y'all. So today is Wednesday. I don't know what the date is. I like to say the date so that way I can remember when I recorded the video, but then I never really know what date it is. So anyway, I went and worked out this morning, did my water stuff. I've been doing that still 3 days a week. The water aerobics, the water Zumba, and the arthritis wellness thing, which is pretty much just water aerobics because I don't think I've told y'all about the water, the arthritis stuff. So, as y'all probably could imagine, at 8 o'clock in the morning, it's just a class full of old ladies, which is fine because I don't have to worry about any foolishness. But, them old ladies be in there getting it, y'all. I'm close to 30, but this body, I commend them. If I have not said that to y'all before, it's a workout in that water, regardless of age, gender, whatever your status is for your health, your condition, it's a workout. So, I have been doing that, which I'm really excited about. Causes a lot of pain. Saw the orthopedist, got new medication, and I've been taking that, trying to make sure that, I'm pretty sure y'all saw that picture that I posted, which was like a rude awakening for me of all the pills and everything that I have to put inside my body. But today is a better day. It's a new day. And I am not going to let that stress me out because I have good news to share with you guys, which you'll have to wait for just a second. Oh, I hate when YouTubers do that. I hate that. But I'm so excited to share like all of like my update with everybody. So I've been doing the water, aerobics and all that good stuff. I went and saw the orthopedist. The first thing he says to me is, oh, you have, a bad hip on the left and the right one that's soon to go out. And I'm just like, okay, thanks doc. Yeah. That I know. So, he said that he'll see me again in a month and see if the medication works and the combination, and then talk about maybe surgery, or I don't know what the next step will be, but we'll talk about it. And I'm kind of in a rush to get it fixed, but I didn't like gain 600 pounds in like a rush, and I have not lost it quickly either. So I have to be patient, but I was telling everybody today that I talked to, I'm like, give me a new hip, give me a new knee, whatever you want to give me, a new whatever. I'm kind of obviously scared of the procedure and the recovery and the pain, pretty much. But I've had two major surgeries in my life, and I'm in pain every single day right now. So what's another couple months of pain and recovery when there is a new life ahead after that? So I'm really excited. I have a lot of things obviously that I always tell y'all about. I want to be able to shop and go to the amusement parks and play with all the babies, and I could use some new bones and joints and hips and whatever else they want to give me. So anyway, that's exciting. I went today. Remember I was telling y'all about my leg, like, so the way that he explained it easier for me is that I'm pretty much knock-kneed more severely on my left side. Excuse me. And what he has to do with the brace is take my left leg from looking like this, and he has to actually put whatever the brace is, the mechanism from having my leg, it's like literally bent in at an angle. He's going to pull it out to where my leg will straighten back out from being knock-kneed. That's the easiest way that I can explain it. So it's definitely going to be a lot of pain. He's literally pulling my knee from the outside or from the inside out to make it straight instead of looking like that. So, I'm not ready for that pain either. But like I said, I'm in pain every day already, so I might as well do something to fix it. My leg was like an inch too big for the brace that he had in the office. So he said he has to pull some catalogs and call some people and see if we need to maybe get a brace specially made. I did tell him that I am losing weight. And then of course skin removal and all that good stuff. So we will be able to maybe find one that we can adjust, hopefully. So he said it'll be about a week or two maybe before he can find one that'll actually fit my leg, but he took measurements and everything, so I'm excited about that process. So that was that, and on to the numbers. So we know that I have 88 pounds to lose to get to my goal weight, which I talk to the people that I pay for professional advice, and my aunt, who's a professional, who told me that I need to set a realistic goal, who I roll my eyes at, and if she's watching this, she knows that I'm rolling my eyes at her right now. But everybody can, well, they told me I need to set realistic goals and make sure that I am not setting myself up for failure or frustration or depression, anxiety, whatever, if I fail to meet this goal that I've set for myself. I'm stubborn, and I'm still going to try my absolute hardest to lose my 88 pounds by April 29th. However, I have some new options now to consider to make it easier on my mind, because I'm already crazy and you already know that I'm crazy. So I don't need to add any unnecessary stress on my little brain. So she said that, what if instead of saying that you want to meet be at your goal weight, why don't we say you lose 300 pounds by 30? Or why don't you say that you're under 300 pounds by 30 instead of hitting your goal weight by 30? So I'm like, okay, yeah, with a whole bunch of eye rolling and sass, it's great. If I don't meet my ultimate goal of being at 250 pounds, then whatever. I'm not going to like die, but so I'm a little more at ease. But okay, so the first week has been, I think it's been 3 weeks now since I've started this little goal. Yeah, I think I've weighed in 3 times. The first week I lost 5.4. The second week I didn't talk to y'all because I only lost 1 pound, and I was super annoyed by that because I feel like the problem is I've never weighed myself this regularly since I've had surgery. Like before, when I did Weight Watchers, I always would, we weighed once a week. So now, like since surgery, I probably only weighed myself like once a month. Like, so every time I went, it was a huge weight loss. I was losing 10, 20 pounds or whatever, and I was fine with that. But now I'm weighing every single week, and it's jacking up my mind. So last week I lost a pound. So this week I went, I'm just like, whatever, I don't know. I feel like it's about to be Shark Week, and I'm just like, okay, whatever it is. Well, I weighed on my scale at home, and I'm like, I think I kind of know what I lost, but I needed to get to the doctor's office to get on my scale there, or their scale there, and weigh. So I weighed this week, and I lost 12 pounds, y'all. That's not even the good news, though. I am officially down 301 pounds total. I've lost 301 pounds. I am so excited. Y'all always make me cry. Like, I'm not gonna cry, but I'm so, so, so excited. Like, I don't know how I did it. I know how I did it, and I know what it's taken to get to this point. But it's like, I've literally, like right now, I weigh 318 pounds. Like my highest weight was 319. My current weight is 318. Like it doesn't, or I'm sorry, it was 619 to 318. I don't know what I said. But it's like, if somebody were, I told she's like the best lady. She's just the front desk. Well, not just, because it's hard work doing this, but she works at the front desk at my office, or my doctor's office, and she comes back around the thing and she just lets me in so she doesn't have to bother the doctors or the nurses just to use the scale. So I'm like, she's my favorite lady at the office, like, period. And she's like always cheering me on. She's giving me high fives and she's hugging me, and she's like, she notices me every time I walk into the office, and it's just like, she just a wonderful, wonderful lady. I love her. But we were standing there talking. I got on the scale 3 times today, by the way, and it said the exact same thing. So we were talking anyway, long story short, and I'm like, if somebody were to put a bodysuit or a bag of 300 pounds on me and ask me to pick it up or move with it, I'm like, I don't think I could do it. And I don't know how this little frame that I'm finding under this body carried all of that weight. Like, I was telling this is a sidebar. I'll tell you that sidebar in a second. But I was talking to my grandpa today, and he's like, do you feel like you really lost that much? He's like, it's amazing because you see it on TV when people lose, you know, these hundreds and hundreds of pounds. But he's like, he never thought that it was really possible. And he asked me, he's like, how do you feel? And it dawned on me that when I look back at my old pictures, I still don't see the 600-pound life that I see on TV. I'm like, those people are fat, but like I'm fat, but those people are fatter than me, even though I probably weigh more than some of the people that I've even seen on that show. But when I look at a picture from back then, I can remember the thoughts that I was having in that moment. As that picture was taken, I can remember how upset I was, how much pain I was in, how embarrassed I was to be taking a picture of me, or how just the pure misery that I was in that moment. Like, and there are a few pictures that I use that are my before pictures, the one with the gray pants on, and there's another, like a bunch of just other pictures that I'm pretty sure y'all have all seen on social, you know, my social media and stuff. But like, I can remember just like the pain. And now, like, when I was talking to him, I'm like, now when I look at pictures of myself, it's like I'm looking at, like, I see joy and I see happiness, and there is light in my face and in my smile. It's a huge difference. Y'all, stop doing this to me. Okay. So let me tell y'all this, so I can just get this face together. Ooh, my eyes got red so fast. I called my grandpa today, and I don't always call him as much as I should. And I'm glad I saved this part for now, because this face, oh man. I called my grandpa, and I'm like, "Hi, Papa, it's Nita. How are you?" And he's like, "Who is this?" And I said, "It's Anita." And he's like, "Well, I'm sorry. I don't know anybody by that name. I think you have the wrong number." So, of course, I bust out laughing, because my grandpa, he's just hilarious. He's the cutest thing ever on earth. And I love hearing his laugh. Like, his laughter is like an angel singing. I know I'm probably being dramatic, but I love hearing my grandpa laugh. But he's like, "The granddaughter I used to have..." And this is absolutely no shade for my grandpa. He did not mean any harm by it or anything. And I will laugh at this for the rest of my life, because I know how proud of me he is. He said that the granddaughter I used to have used to be a big old gray fat thing. And I was just like, then he's like, "Now you're just a little old Slim Jim over there." And I'm like, I am literally cracking up at the top of my lungs, because first of all, who says that? Who says that? Like, but you know, old people say what they want to say, and he absolutely meant no harm. And I was a great big old fat thing. Like, you don't just, you're not 619 pounds and think you're just like walking around like you're not the big elephant in the room. Like, but he just was like, when I told him how much I lost, he's like, "Oh my God," he's like, "That is just so wonderful." And if you know my grandpa, he's a man of very few words. And like, for him to just sit there, and I could picture him, he's just shaking his head, and he's like, "I'm just so proud of you. I'm just so happy. I can't believe you did it. And you keep up the good work." And he's just like, y'all, I'm about to cut this off, because y'all not about to have me just really like in here boo-hooing. Where is the Kleenex, Jesus? So, I'm super happy. I'm so very blessed to be still living, even though sometimes in my past I have felt like I didn't want to live, or I felt like I prayed to not wake up, or whatever the case may have been in the past. I know that today is a new day, and if I am able to see tomorrow, it'll be another day for me to accomplish, you know, another goal, or set a new goal, or try something different that I have not done up until now. So I am super excited. I hear my neighbor's dog going outside right now, so it's about to be kind of noisy. So I'm going to let you guys go. But I love y'all so much. I appreciate y'all for always watching my videos and sharing and being on this journey with me. Whatever journey you're on, you know that you need support. You know that you know how much it means to you when people actually are there to motivate you and encourage you. And y'all mean the world to me. And I say that every single chance I get. So here is to seeing less of me and more of you. Oh, I'm down 20 pounds in those 3 weeks. I have 68 pounds to go of my 88 to get down to my goal. Doesn't have to be by April 29th. However, we got 68 pounds to go. Here's to seeing less of me and more of you. I love y'all so much, and I'll see y'all next time. Bye.